my hearing started to get worse and worse. And it was probably my wife Diane that started to notice it. And one day she says, you know, Frank, I'm a little concerned about you riding the bike. And you've got to hear the cars, you got to hear the horns, you got to react in a split second. And she really started to get concerned for my safety because I just wasn't hearing, you know, that well. I wasn't alert to the things around me. And that's what ultimately brought it to the point where I really just drifted off from the riding. And it was spending, bike was spending most of the time in the garage.
My husband's long life dream was to own a custom made chopper. Am I allowed to say that I thought it was a chopper from hell because of all of the spikes and all of the flames and everything on it? It's amazing, and it's been a lifelong dream, and he finally has it. It has become a little dangerous because he can't hear anything around him, and it's not very safe for him to ride it. He scares me on the chopper because of the unsafety.
Frank is dynamic, creative, loud, inspirational, instigative, and good and bad. All around, he's my hero.
He is a man of integrity, a man that loves deep and wide, and a man of great understanding.
He's energetic, he's dynamic, he's someone who makes everyone in the room feel important, and someone who's always there engaging with people.
He's very caring, and he cares about what I care about, and when I feel deeply, he feels deeply. Whatever is important to you is important to him.
I think what has probably influenced my life the most is just his level of reality and humility. He will walk in a place of transparency. He doesn't think of himself higher than anybody else, and he really brings that in a very real level.
Frank is a man who loves life, loves to live it, loves to watch his children and his grandchildren play, and loves to eat Italian food.
This is having a good red sauce. This is the greatest evidence I know. It says God is Italian. This is it right here.
I like things loud. I like my worship music loud. I like, music at home loud. I mean, when I have my headset on, I just like it loud. I make this joke. I say, if it's not loud enough to make my ears bleed, then it's just not loud enough. And I mean, you know, I played in a rock band when I was in high school, and I played in a rock band when I was in college.
He does listen to the music very loud. When he goes into prayer or goes into study, he likes an environment of music. So you'll get that environment of his music all over the building.
We've noticed it for a long period of time. It just seems like it has gotten worse. When he was in the construction business, we would notice it because he'd be on job sites and he was around loud equipment, and he would wear plugs in his ears, and so it seemed like he would come home and just almost have to almost like regroup and go, I'm sorry, what? And then he'd go, oh, I'm sorry, I was just on the equipment all day long, so I'm, you know, my hearing is still adjusting.
He began to miss conversations. I began to, as we had a conversation, I would talk to him later about it and say, hey, what happened with this situation? And he would go, I don't know what you're talking about. And I go, well, you and I just talked about it briefly. You know, I threw it out there to you. And he said, and he would go, I don't remember that. I remember talking to you, but I don't remember what we were talking about. And so after that, you know, Frank is a guy that listens. He's a good listener. So I began to notice he would miss things because he's not hearing it. It's not because he's trying to miss it. He's not hearing it.
Frank is a brilliant man. He misses very little. In conversation and what's going around him. And I had mentioned something to him very personally, that was very personal to me in a one-on-one conversation. And later on, about a week or two, he asked me the same question. And it was a lengthy conversation. And I realized at that point that he was probably missing a lot more than he realized.
I'm Betty Vosters Kemp, and I'm a licensed hearing healthcare provider. My husband, Michael, is an audiologist, and he and I were married about 25 years ago and started this practice. Often when you have a hearing loss, it's the family that's more concerned than the hard of hearing person, because for most of us, hearing loss comes on so gradually, and our brains and our eyes start taking over and filling in the missing pieces. So again, you know, if it's the husband with the hearing loss, it's often the wife that notices he's disconnected or missing things.
I didn't probably notice as much. So once we moved here and we actually put ourselves around TV in volumes of things, then I realized there was more of a hearing loss.
The truth is, you know, in this day and age, we're all losing our hearing because we live in such a noisy world.
Is there truly something going on here? And the biggest thing that I saw was music always being super loud. It's TVs being so loud that I literally get a headache and have to leave the room and cannot watch TV with my husband.
She would say, Frank, turn down your iPod. I can hear it. Now she'd be sitting next to me on the couch or in bed or in the car or whatever. And she would say, I'd be listening to it so loud on my iPod that she could hear it next to me. And I'd be thinking, you know, I'd look down at the numbers and this would just be the normal, it didn't sound loud to me. It would be like the normal volume. And so I think that's probably when I first started to realize that it might not be just a preference to where I like loud music.
Nobody wants to admit that you're beginning to lose your hearing, and people don't realize that by the time you reach the age of 30, we're starting to already lose some of our hearing. It's normal in our society. It's so normal. We've been listening to music really loud. Baby boomers, we were going to rock concerts and listening to our music through, you know, our great stereo system. Today, we're listening through to music through earbuds. And, you know, if you walk next to someone and they're 3 feet away from you and you can hear their music through their earbuds, they're damaging their hearing. So there's that whole stigma that hearing loss is something that happens to old people. It's not true anymore.
I think it's ego. I think it's pride. And I think it's embarrassing for him. Your pride is taken away if you have to say there's something wrong and that you're not completely whole. You know, I don't see it that way. I don't look at that way. I don't think of him as anything less or different. But I think the way he's been raised, if you're not 100% and you're not it, A, then there's something wrong.
When we grew up, the hearing aids were these big, huge chunks of plastic hanging out the side of your head that looked like a huge earphone. And no one wants to walk around with that because it's kind of a pride issue. Why do you need help? No one needs help if you're a guy. You're a man. You don't need help. You can just do things yourself and figure out ways to make it work. That's what we do all life long is figure out how to make it work. But with something with your hearing or your eyesight or something like that, you shouldn't be taking corners. You just need to get it fixed.
No one wants to go to the doctor. No one wants to be sick. And so no one wants hearing loss. Now it's a point where it's not just affecting him, it's affecting people around him. And so that's the big thing.
We'll have a staff meeting and we'll come to conclusions on things. And just for the sake of time and his busy schedule he's always in, he'll nod his head and agree to things. He didn't hear it. Like it was discussed and he said, yeah, just to end it, but he never even heard actually what was said.
On which device?
No, which device are you calling? Who?
Home phone.
Whose phone is it going to be that you'll be calling? Is it her phone?
Like a cell phone, house phone, maybe?
Is it a house phone or a cell phone?
No, what phone are you going to call? Are you going to call your mom on her cell phone or her house phone?
On the other end, what device is it?
And when we get together, everybody's having their own conversation. And so there'll be a conversation here and there and over there. And people will just bounce back and forth, and he used to be able to do that, and now he can't. And so it doesn't frustrate me. I would say it's sad.
I try to be a little more forgiving because I'm pretty sure at the time when I'm watching him interact with other people that is what's happening is he's focusing. But is he focusing on what they're actually saying and really thinking about his response? Or is he focusing on, is this exactly what they said, and did I hear it right? I know that he wants to fully engage with them. And I think that sometimes he can't, but he really, really tries.
My husband loves to meet with people. He loves to be around them. He also loves to input into their lives and help them figure life out and bring healing to their lives and restoration. And I found that he meets with less and less people all the time because of the lack of being able to hear what they're saying. And I think if he was able to hear them better, that wouldn't be happening. He would actually be able to meet with them and have a better understanding of what's going on.
I had a young couple who had just experienced a miscarriage, and it was on their first baby. And I have to tell you, it's one of the more heartbreaking moments you have, because, you know, it's young kids, they're married, they're exciting, you know, maybe they've waited 2 or 3 years, they're finally ready to have a baby, and all of a sudden a miscarriage comes, and it really shakes them. And I was sitting with a couple, blessed, I mean, precious couple, and she is sharing about what it feels, and I see this young man, and he's just trying to understand and be comforting. He doesn't know what to say or do. He just wants to be a comfort, and he's looking at me and expecting me, and I kid you not, I cannot hear a word she is saying. She is crying, of course, in the tears. Maybe she's mumbling a bit or something, but she's just pouring out all of this, and I didn't know what to do. Do I stop her, you know, and say, hey, man, I can't hear a word you're saying, or do I let it go or whatever? And ultimately, I didn't want to stop her, and I certainly couldn't ask her to repeat herself, but it's tough, you know. You need to be able to hear.
Well, I'm noticing that he does this more, so I'm assuming that it's gotten worse, and it seems to be in more situations.
At the end of the 11, when we came back up.
And we sit in the movie theaters, and he sits there and watches the movie with his ears cupped because he can't hear the movies, and we're in the movie theater that's built with sound systems. Like, it's built so you don't have to worry about hearing. It's built that way. And he still has to sit there in the corner, his ears cupped, and it's just things like that.
He will go along with what you say so well, even if he can't hear it. You know, you don't fully realize it. And I don't know that that's such a good thing. It's probably somewhat of a bad thing, because if he doesn't have the full information, he's walking out of a situation and doesn't have it, then you think he does, and that's probably more detrimental than if he went, hey, I didn't get what you said, you know.
In a social setting around the kids or the grandkids, you know, everybody will be laughing, and I'll just laugh right along. I was with my sons, Bryce, Tanner, and Connor, and Ryan, kind of like my adopted son, and we're having a cigar in the garage the other night, and literally, sometimes they would laugh, and they'd just be roaring, and I didn't even hear what the joke was, so I just laugh along, you know, just because it just gets old. It gets old. You get tired of working so hard, and so you just kind of give up and go with the flow.
But Brighton's never had that opportunity to realize that he couldn't hear.
Yeah, like, so he said thank you the other night, and Pastor Frank, you know, responded back, and it wasn't like the answer to thank you, and Brighton was just looking at him, and we, you know, someone else in the room said, he said thank you, you know, and he's like, oh, you're welcome, you know, and responded back.
I realize that I am missing a chunk of change. I'm missing a lot of things in my life, important things. I'm missing my grandkids. I have to ask them to repeat things 2 or 3 times. Jade Gabriel, my little Downs angel, I'll have to ask him to repeat things.
No, not he. He's no. Got brings a lot. He went to China when he first got married.
So I don't think First Samuel.
That is good.
Yeah. Yeah. Right?
What was that?
First Samuel.
First Samuel chapter 1 through verse.
People are frustrated because I've drugged my feet for so long to get this thing figured out. I think the level of frustration now probably is way more than it should have ever been if I hadn't been quite so vain or quite so anti-hearing aid in general. I think it would have happened a lot sooner. But I think people are just frustrated with me. You know, they're tired of saying, would you please go get your hearing checked? And so there's a high level of frustration in my marriage, my family, my kids, the office staff.
Dream is going to be book only and not any video of you whatsoever.
You said it again. I didn't hear you. I'm sorry.
The way the system is set up is the
getting help with hearing aids isn't a big deal. If you get it and you go through that process and see how easy it is to get help, your lives can be radically transformed. And I wanted to see that for Frank.
It was so good when Connor showed up.
That was a great surprise.
Yeah, that was really a meaningful moment.
And it was a nice surprise for him too, because your car wasn't out there.
You kept asking.
Hold on a second. Want to hear something really funny? I never heard what you said just now, and I am so in the mode of laughing, even though I don't hear something. I just laughed.
Really?
That is the perfect example right really? There. You said something, you were laughing, and I'm so trained as not to ask, what did you say? I laughed along with you. And it just dawned on me, I just did it.
Wow, that's interesting.
That's really, isn't it?
You had me fooled.
I know.
I thought we were laughing together.
Seriously.
Wow. Is that a lie?
No, it's not a lie. It's my life.
Oh. Whatever, doing it, Frank.
Thank you. You too.
I'm Betty.
Hi, Betty.
I'm going to be helping you with your hearing today.
Very good.
So I'm going to have a peek inside your ears, because wouldn't it be great if it was just earwax? Probably not, but we're going to rule that out first, okay? So a little bit of wax way up top on the ear canal, but it's not interfering at all with your hearing, because I can see that eardrum. So the first thing I like to do is find out just how well you're hearing and understanding. So I'm going to give you a word list, but I'm going to have you close your eyes and repeat these words to the best of your ability, okay?
Okay.
Say the word loud.
Loud.
Say the word boat.
Say again.
Say the word pool.
Pool.
Say the word nag.
I don't know what word you said.
Okay. Say the word gap.
Gap.
Say the word fat.
Fact.
Say the word met.
Next.
Say the word jar.
Jar.
Say the word door.
Door.
Good. You can relax and open your eyes.
Okay.
You're getting 60% clarity. Does that surprise you?
I'm surprised that it's that bad.
Are you?
Yeah. Like they...
And that's in
like
quiet.
I was concentrating as hard as I could.
I saw
but
that.
If my eyes were open, I would have been much better.
Yeah, like if I say the word met.
Met.
Yeah, you said next.
Next?
Next. When your ears were doing the work only, not your eyes, your brain and your ears, you said next.
Yeah, and I hadn't thought about it until just now, but I guess I do hear that there's sound out there. Mm-hmm. I just don't know what it exactly is that they're saying.
Yeah. So when you are only getting 60% clarity, you're working overtime to figure out what people are saying, even in a quiet room. Mm-hmm. Even in a quiet room or when there's background noise like we just had there, you're really working hard to follow that conversation. Okay. All right, let's put you in the sound booth. Thank you. I'll remember that if it's ever
Sam's
needed.
Not here.
Huh? Another baby boomer joke.
Yeah.
Cheech and Chong.
Sorry, you have to be my age.
Watch your step, please. I'm going to start with your right ear first. And you're going to hear those beeps. They're going to start out loud and clear, but they get real quiet. So even if you barely hear the sound, let me know by raising your hand. Okay? Here we go. All right. I have this software program called a hearing loss simulator, and I would love for Ryan to hear through your ears.
Okay.
Because it's a real eye-opener. So this is a couple in a noisy restaurant talking, woman and a man.
So, how did your presentation go at the manager's meeting?
Well, I didn't even get to start. Everyone had just gotten seated when one of the assistants interrupted with some urgent problem from our overseas office.
So this is normal. This is Frank. This is Frank.
That's good, man. You were pretty excited with your presentation.
Yeah, I've been working on it for about 2 weeks now.
So, when do you get to present it?
Can you hear that?
Is that bad?
You can't hear me.
I couldn't understand the first one, let alone the second one.
Because the first one sounds like this to Frank through his ears. Mm-hmm. So it's sort of like the guy's voice isn't bad, but the woman's voice is like somebody's got...
I can't even hear it.
Can't understand it. Mm-hmm. This is how it could be.
Well, I didn't even get to start.
This is how it is.
Wow.
Huge, huge difference.
Dude, you might be able to hear again.
That would be lovely.
Come on, man. That'd be awesome.
That would be awesome.
Okay. So I'm going to go get a couple of samples of hearing aids, and then we're going to look to see what really is going to work for you personally and for your lifestyle. Okay?
Okay.
Okay. So now I'm just going to calibrate the hearing instrument. So you're going to hear a bunch of beeps, bells, and buzzes.
Okay.
And we can't talk. We have to be quiet for a minute. Ready? Okay. How are you doing, Frank?
Good.
Good, yes. So did I take the mush out of my mouth? Do I sound a little bit clearer and sharper to you?
Crystal clear.
It sounds very artificial the first few hours.
Okay.
Okay. And then your brain starts getting used to it because you haven't heard the sh 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 tss, tss, f, f, s, s sounds for a long time.
Yeah.
For a long time.
Yeah.
And suddenly I threw you into a pool full of those sounds. And even like the chair, you know.
Oh, you're kidding me.
No, I'm not. Do you have keys
Paper
in your pocket?
Sound?
Do you have keys in your pocket, anybody?
No.
Anybody have keys?
This is a whole new world. Some people must get freaked out.
Yes, yes. I think you're
only
freaking
those,
out.
I think you're freaking out.
Some people, yes.
I'm starting to sweat. I mean, I heard you pull Kleenex out of a box.
Oh, Mike, did
wow.
you?
Wow.
Yeah. It's a sound, right? You don't get that sound through your ears.
I can hear your wheels of your
yeah,
chair.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. I can hear my foot on the floor.
Mm-hmm.
I can hear a whisper.
Unbutton, like, your pocket. Unbutton a pocket. Yeah, yeah. It has a sound.
Oh, dear geez, I can't believe it. That's amazing.
Yeah. So.
Really?
I'm going to make a little
crazy.
Adjustment for you.
You can hear this, can you, from there?
I can hear that.
You can?
Yeah.
Okay.
And now let's take a walk out into the real world. What do you think?
I hear birds.
Yes.
I hear that car. I hear the leaves. I hear the traffic. I hear wind.
Yeah.
Wow.
So let's walk out way to the traffic and see how you do, because really what you want to hear most of all is people, right?
Mm-hmm.
And not just hear them, but have the clarity and the understanding.
Right.
So that you're not working so hard.
Right.
Right?
Yeah.
Are you working hard right now to understand
no,
me?
No. I can hear every word you're saying.
Nice.
Clear as a bell.
Good.
Whoa, that traffic is loud.
Is it loud?
Yeah. It is really loud.
Yeah. And that really loud traffic, are you still picking up my voice okay?
Yeah, I hear you clearly.
Yeah? Okay.
Yeah.
What's your favorite flavor of ice cream?
Rocky Road. I am stunned at how loud the cars are. I can hear the echo off that building of
mm-hmm.
the cars driving by.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I can hear so much sound, I feel like I'm in a movie, you know, like, you
mm-hmm.
know, like a science fiction film where all of a sudden mm-hmm. you hear everything. Like you have superpowers. I feel like Spider-Man. That's what I feel like, Spider-Man.
That's true.
I kid you not. I'm serious. It's like I have super senses. Like right now, I think I hear better than all of you. That's
so
how dramatic.
You couldn't hear these things before?
I couldn't hear any of it.
Really?
None of it. I can hear every little car. I can hear them going over the little bump over there, whatever it is. The
yeah. Yeah.
Yeah,
the
sewer cap,
cover.
The manhole cover.
Yeah.
I mean, I can hear. I kid you not, I can hear. Yeah, this is perfect.
Okay.
Okay. Awesome.
Initially, your brain is going to be so busy picking up subtle little things.
Uh-huh.
And the brain is wired to notice what's different.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. As your brain gets used to that paper actually has a sound, and that when you take tissues out of the tissue box, it actually has a sound.
Yeah.
Your brain won't bring your attention to it anymore.
Oh, I see.
But right now, every little sound, even the guys walking on the grass, has a sound.
Yep.
And you're going to notice that.
Right.
Okay?
Very good.
Yeah.
Very good.
Thank you.
Uh-huh.
Good.
So, thank you. It's been just wonderful working with you. I totally get this is going to change your life.
Yeah,
and
well.
Thank you for allowing me to be part of that.
Thank you so much. You did a great job. You're
thank
very
you.
Good.
We hug it out.
Oh, very good.
We all hug it out.
Oh, look, and you're not even whistling. Can I hug you on the side? Good. All right. That's a good thing. We don't want you whistling.
Thanks very much. I appreciate
thank
it.
You. Take care, you guys. Drive safe.
Thanks.
All right. I can literally hear footsteps.
Really?
Really. I kid you not.
Being in that office was just It was so crazy because when he put those hearing aid, when he put the hearing aids on and she made those adjustments, and now he is hearing the air conditioner and he's unbuttoning his shirt and he can hear it. And he didn't know. He didn't know that this made a noise. He didn't know that pulling a tissue out of a tissue box made noise. Those things, seeing him be able to now hear those things that he has missed for who knows how many years, was absolutely amazing.
One of the first things he said to me is, I owe you an apology. I go, well, not just one, but how many? You know, so he's like joking around as a wife, and he goes, I do shuffle. He shuffles his feet. He doesn't pick them up and walk. And I've been saying it for years, I go, baby, why do you shuffle? Pick your feet up. He goes, I don't shuffle. I go, you baby, you shuffle. And so he calls me in Arizona. He goes, I shuffle. I hear myself. So that was one of the first things he noticed, because he didn't hear it. But he goes, and I do, I slam doors, and I didn't realize. I walk into a room loudly, I close doors loudly. He's, I am loud. I go, yes, you are.
I think, Frank, I would say he is must be at least 90%, maybe more, because he actually, I can tell, instead of sitting there maybe and doodling or whatever and kind of looking up every now and then, he actually will be able to respond and come back with his input on that situation. And I think it's just because now he can hear.
Someone in the audience had made a comment, and always in the past, we've always had to have that person mic'd or repeat himself. And for the first time ever this weekend, someone said something, and he heard exactly what they said the first time. And that's never happened before in service. It's always been like repeating, what'd you say? And it gets awkward and that kind of stuff. But he was able to hear the very first time when someone commented out loud during the message. So that's when that happened. I was like, he can hear that, finally.
It's like 100% quality. I mean, it's completely changed. I don't have to yell anymore. I don't have to go, Frank. It's just, hey, babe. You know, even just here in the house, instead of having to scream, hey, you know, where's Jade? It's just, hey, babe, where's Jade? I just can have a normal conversation with him and not have to yell, where's Jade? It's completely changed.
There's definitely been a difference in Frank's ability to perceive what's happening when he's speaking on stage more. Which has been both good and bad. One, because we've been having a few sound issues where, you know, where there's light feedback on his microphone, whereas before he might gloss over it, or he may or may not pick it up. Now he's definitely going to pick it up, and he's going to go, hey, there was feedback on my mic. What'd you do? You know, what'd you do back there with the sound? And I'm going to have to, you know, kind of figure that out. But there's definitely the sensitivity where he can hear things when he's speaking, when he sound checks, when he speaks from the stage, that he couldn't hear before.
Just working with him and being around him, the improvement has been, 100% of just a noticeable difference, a huge noticeable difference. There's no more of the, you know, hands behind the ears, or him asking, you know, what did you say again over and over again, or just kind of giving you that smile and nodding like he's trying to process what you said. There's just been none of that there, so it's just been a level of engagement that wasn't there really before.
He listens to stuff lower, like even radio, everything, like you said, it's so low, and he talks so low, it has completely changed.
Over the last 3 weeks, I haven't heard his playlist, you know what I mean? We know which songs he's playing because he's always playing the same songs, but we haven't heard his playlist unless he's really excited about something he wants everybody to hear, then he'll crank it up. But other than that, he's playing it at a different decibel level.
Hearing again has changed everything. I had no idea how exhausting it is to sit there and try and hear people and to cleverly go, you know, like you're rubbing your head, you know, like this, and you're trying to get that bounce thing going, and you're leaning in, you know, almost invading people's space. And I just didn't realize how tiring that is.
I went to a movie with him the other day, and for the first time, he heard the entire movie. He wasn't sitting in the theaters like this, like a little weirdo. He just was able to enjoy the movie for the first time.
We went to a comedy this last Monday, and I didn't have to ask for a single punchline. And it was one of those real witty comedies where it wasn't so much a long, funny story as it was a bunch of funny one-liners. And so I got to sit there and eat my popcorn. I heard every single word.
We had a chaplaincy graduation, and there was a large amount of people. I think there was 15 of us all at a table, and he was able to communicate with everybody at the table because he could hear everybody.
I am so addicted to hearing now that not only do I not care whether it's this little thing back here or a little thing in here, they could be as big as headsets, and I would not go without them. That is how much hearing again has impacted my life. I could care less what it looks like. I will not be without it.
We had a barbecue the other day with the family and the kids, and he was able to have a normal conversation and engage rather than just listen as best he could. Like, he was actually able to engage and respond because he knew what they were saying rather than trying to figure out what they were saying.
On Father's Day, it was so sweet because we, first of all, we're spread out over several tables on the backyard, and I can hear the girls talking about girl stuff and God stuff. I can hear the guys talking about movies and cigars and guy stuff. And at the same time, I'm listening to both conversations. Jade Gabriel and I and the dog, we're on another planet all by ourselves having a total different dog conversation. And it was fun. I didn't have to work. I mean, I was relaxed. I was enjoying it because every word is coming in.
Just watching the joy on him has been probably the biggest change. Watching what he hears, how he hears, how he reacts to hearing different things he's never heard before. That's probably the most exciting part.
And I literally can hear the kids playing. I can hear the pump in the pool. I can hear the air conditioning unit. I can hear all of the voices. I can hear the birds. I can hear the neighbor mowing his lawn over the fence. I can hear everything. The interesting thing was, as I was sitting there and it even dawned on me that I could hear everything, all of a sudden I heard the kids arguing. I heard one of the kids cry out, my little granddaughter, Ari, and immediately I stood up. I was the first one to go back, walk in, make sure everything was okay, and everything was okay. Her lion had gotten eaten by T-Rex, but short of that, it was a good moment. But I would have never heard that.
All everywhere.
You're making a home everywhere?
For the owl.
For the owl?
Wow.
It's a lion.
Jade doesn't get frustrated with his dad. He doesn't have to say the same things over and over. They're just completely interacting. He can just talk to him and not say, "Dad, ugh." And he just talks to him and they have a great interaction, and he can actually whisper to him and they laugh and they giggle and he's hearing him.
Mama.
It's your mom.
He's just able to engage a lot more with Jade. So that's exciting to see because, you know, it's his son. He deserves to be able to experience his son. And now for the first time, he can experience what Jade experiences.
I got you.
I know.
The pajama.
Okay. 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 So this is Jade Gabriel, my son. Can you say hi, Jade?
Hi.
Okay. So he is my angel. He is my little angel. And not missing a word he says is probably the thing that I'm looking most forward to, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. It's really changed my life. The bike doesn't sit in the garage anymore. In fact, it spends more time on the street than it does in the garage. And that would have never happened if I hadn't gotten my hearing back. It's just given me back something that was such a part of my life that I had lost, and now it's come back, and it's better than ever. Bye, Grandma.
Bye, Grandma.
Thanks for coming over, guys.
Can you hear me?
What?
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Spidey senses.
I can hear everything. Things. They have not only given me my hearing back, but I have better hearing now than I've ever had before.